Good morning, it's Thursday and we are continuing our series, Praying with the Church. We've had a few days with the early church, one day with the medieval church, today with where we are with the Reformation. We're going to be praying along with John Calvin. He was a lawyer, trained to be a lawyer in Paris, but he ended up in Geneva and in Switzerland and was a church leader there. And is very famous for lots of his writings, and often has quite a bad reputation as being a narrow theologian. And actually, if you read his writings, he was a wonderful, not only theologian, but pastor, and somebody who thought very deeply and devotionally about God and about what it looks like to follow him. The verse that I'd love us to consider today is in Luke chapter 9. I do turn to Luke chapter 9, verse 23. Luke chapter 9, verse 23 reads as follows. Then Jesus said to them all, "Whoever wants to be my disciple must deny themselves and take up their cross daily and follow me." Luke's gospel is unique in recording this additional word, daily. So we have it in the other Gospels as well, this same verse of picking up your cross. What it looks like to be a disciple of the Lord Jesus is to pick up your cross and follow him. But in Luke, we have the additional word as well, to take up your cross daily and follow me. And for John Calvin, there was a very strong sense that he was concerned about how we daily follow the Lord Jesus. And the prayer that we're going to be looking at is a prayer that he encouraged the churches that he pastored to pray daily at the beginning of each day as we set about the things that we're concerned about today. Now, so I'm going to read it to us. There'll be a few points that I'll make as we go along, and then we'll pray it all together. So this is the prayer, a prayer to be said in the morning when rising. My God, my Father and my Saviour, since you've been pleased to give me the grace to come through the night to the present day, now grant also this favour, that I may employ it entirely in your service. I think about what we were learning on Sunday about there is no sacred secular divide. John Calvin, of all of the reformers, had this very strong sense that each day is to be offered to the Lord, that there is no nothing special, particularly about Sunday in comparison to the rest of the week. Every day is an opportunity to serve the Lord. And so we ask that we would employ the day ahead of us entirely to his service. That I may not think, say, or do anything except to please you and obey your good will. So that by this means all my works may be to the glory of your name and the edification of my neighbours. And as you have been pleased to make your sun shine upon the earth to give us bodily light, grant me also the light of your spirit to illumine my understanding and my heart, to direct me in the straight way of your righteousness. Thus, whatever I may apply myself to do, may my chief purpose and intent always be to walk in the fear of you, to serve and honour you, awaiting all my good and prosperity only from your blessing, so as not to attempt anything except what may be pleasing to you. It's just a theme that occurs over and over again in Calvin's writing, but clearly is a reflection of scripture, is that we would live lives that please God. That's the desire of Calvin's heart. That's the desire of every true Christian, is that we would live lives that please him. Moreover, as I am working so much for my body and the present life, may I always keep my eyes fixed above. We live lives here on earth, don't we, with all of the concerns that we may have, but our eyes should always be fixed ahead of us to eternal life. Nevertheless, may you be pleased to be my protector in body and in soul, strengthening me against all the temptations of the devil and delivering me from all the dangers that could befall me. And because it means nothing to begin well if one does not persevere, please receive me into your holy guidance, not only for this day, but for all my life, daily continuing and increasing your grace in me until you have led me to the full union with your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who is the true sun of our souls, shining day and night, eternally and without end. And so that I may also obtain such graces from you, please forget all my past faults, forgiving me by your infinite mercy, as you have promised to all those who seek you with a good heart. Hear me, merciful Father, by our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Wonderful. Just a reminder, daily as we're praying, not only for the forgiveness of our sins, as we're encouraged to do in the Lord's Prayer, but also here that we are forgiven by God's infinite mercy. It's not because each day we pick ourselves up from the day before and get going. No, no. It's because of God's infinite mercy. Let's pray this prayer, which begins us so well for the day ahead. Let's pray. My God, my Father, and my Saviour, since you have been pleased to give me the grace to come through the night to the present day, now grant also this favour, that I may employ it entirely in your service, that I may not think, say, or do anything except to please you and obey your good will, so that by this means all my works may be to the glory of your name and the edification of my neighbours. And as you have been pleased to make your Son shine upon the earth to give us bodily light, grant me also the light of your Spirit to illumine my understanding and my heart, to direct me in the straight way of your righteousness. Thus, whatever I apply myself to do, may my chief purpose and intent always to be to walk in the fear of you, to serve and honour you, awaiting all my good and prosperity only from your blessing, so as not to attempt anything except what may be pleasing to you. Moreover, as I am working so much for my body and the present life, may I always keep my eyes fixed above on the heavenly life you've promised to your children. Nevertheless, be pleased to be my protector in body and in soul, strengthening me against all the temptations of the devil and delivering me from all the dangers that could befall me. And because it means nothing to begin well if one does not persevere, please receive me into your holy guidance, not only for this day, but for all my life, daily continuing and increasing your grace in me until you have led me to the full union with your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who is the true Son of our souls, shining day and night, eternally and without end. And so that I may obtain such graces from you, please forget all my past faults, forgiving me by your infinite mercy, as you have promised to all those who seek you with a good heart. Hear me, merciful Father, by our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.